record, but I don't know. So now they've done these drills before. Now we're going to start with the tangles first. We don't have a lot of time, so come on. Okay, girls, you try to just round up more of the panel and pull up your back. Try not to jump. Okay, I don't really prefer the jump, but she's giving you the right idea.
Thank you.
Really quick. This is for some kids don't turn their roundup over good, right?
Also, if you're gonna build into a round off, which you probably will, the turn of a second hand for a round off is definitely key.
Same thing.
Again, for the hips being square, landing on the V.
Okay,
so that's my big emphasis there. And then
I'm seeing these guys land with a little bit of bent knees on these round offs, so they're not getting.
Another big emphasis is the arms coming off the beam. She has a great pull up, and her arms are squeezing right hip. I do a lot of this with my JV girls because they need to learn how to control themselves on the beam. A lot of them don't know how to stay on the beam. So do one more. So watching her arms, she pulls up, she lifts her chest, she does everything correct. Okay, most typical girls will be all over the place. They have loose arms. So giving them a pull, a tap, a hit, she's already gripping with her toes. That's great. Those are things that you need to teach your JV girls is how to stay on the beam. So I do a lot of poking, hitting. When they're coming up, you can put something at the end of the beam. If you have a foam block, a stuffed animal, I don't care what it is. But as they're coming up, they're looking at that object and focusing on the beam, which is where they want to stay. Okay, if they're all over the place, they're going to be all over the place.
A really good tumbling drill to create power.
So cartwheels, that can turn,
and
those arms coming off the beam, it's really huge.
Especially with the takeoff angles, if you're shoving your feet
when
back.
We're looking at connections for cartwheels.
You know, in our gym, we have a lot of junior Olympic kids, so we do this development coming up. We don't
when we're
do a
looking
lot
at cartwheel connections, that back foot,
still something you can use that's going
to work on that swing kick through and control. I have them kick through to a lunge.
So that's the route. Wait, one more.
Just if they're scared to do the connection, but you want to work on the want to work on the actual drill for it. Hold that back leg. their dominant foot in front is what makes sense to me. Just so they can feel like they have room on the beam. You don't want to ever have them have 2 feet together because, you know, they're going to crack.
Exactly.
Okay. As far as round off drills.
Okay, these are great drills for on the way back.
When they put a round off on the beam, a lot of the times they're going to start crunching up their scale.
Sure, you're getting
so to
this.
Have the round off, we emphasize on stretching it out. You can use a panel mat with the
round off. Okay. The round off,
you're going
to
start with your front foot here.
Too close to
okay,
the board.
You're going to reach your hands to the end and lay your foot on the
floor. Okay. Yeah. It's going to help round off.
You can rebound if you want, whatever you want. Put your foot on the mat. So to have them stretch their round up out, I have them go over a panel mat, and then you can even put this at the edge, a floor beam, so they can start focusing on landing the round up. Like they let
out. Something about this might work really good. Back up a little bit.
Into the round off is important to keep it long and not have it look crunched up. Okay.
Try to turn me a pause.
Can you do a hinge onto the board the same way? You're going to reach long. Yes, but you're going to lock into high relevance.
Okay, this is good. Also,
yeah,
seeing like, you know, how the kids go through and how they progress.
This is a drill to kind of work into round offs. So if they already have a cartwheel dismount that you think is successful, build in this skill. So they'll do the good stretch, and then they'll work into a relevant lock position. And two, if they're having trouble with their cartwheel dismount, this is another drill to do. Teaches them to stay long, teaches them to lock up nice and tall, which is where you want them to start any type of back. And this will be beginners for round offs as well. Once they have this drill understood, then we would. Have you guys seen those little foam bathroom mats, like at, I don't know, Target, Aldi? Well, you can use those to put them on the beam so that when they're learning round offs, part of the thing is they're afraid of the landing that's going to occur when they hit that beam with 2 feet together. So what you can do, I didn't bring one, is put a little pad though. So after they get this basic drill, can you do the round off one more time? Once the round off looks good here, then you can move it onto the actual low beam. And that's when I would put the pad and mat when they're first learning it. Because you don't want them to hurt their feet and then be afraid of the landing. So if you put that foam mat and if the bottom has that like rubber sticky stuff on the bottom, it won't slide on the beam. So you don't need to be afraid of that. But you would do the same drill, a round off onto the mats, panel mats. So panel mats on each side of the beam with the mat. Have them get the round off going. And once it's without the panel mats, still keep that foam mat there to let them still build that round off and land correctly. And then take that foam mat away at the very end so that they can feel confident and not feel like they're going to hurt the feet when they land. And then when you're ready to build the hurdle into the round off, you can still do this drill. So you step in front of the mat and the hurdle would come on top. And then she would do the round off.
Right.
She's taking up, okay. And then measure that.
Some of this is not
quality,
might
not
have
any. Okay.
Okay, so that's for the entry.
The other thing, if your girls are having like a problem doing the lift with the snap of the round off, like a really beginner JV, you can actually stand here and as they're doing the round off, you can help get that lift. Obviously, I don't have to with her, but if her hands are staying on the mat a long time, I can lift them up so she feels that proper
showing
position
the shape.
And the lift.
Also
so that's something you could spot if you needed to with your real beginner JV girls.
Putting her shoulders right over
thank
her
you
hands.
Very much. Oh, wait.
She doesn't enter for you.
One more for the roundup.
Will not be right over her hands, but they need to get there.
From a lunge.
Okay, so that's the memory that I want.
You're okay. That takes care of the drive that should be happening in a roundup. You can also put a band on this, and then you could also do a slider where she's gonna send the slider from her back foot.
One thing.
She's gonna send it backwards on her needle kick. Okay.
Question is, how deep do you want it to shake?
The direction it's going tells you that kick is happening over the body, or if they're kicking around the side in the roundup. You can watch that slider and see where it goes.
Tight in their back.
And that's for even more advanced skills, like if you ever teach an aerial.
Come up a little bit.
Or front walk over, anything like that.
Know your athlete, know their body.
Watching a slider gives you an idea of why they're having issues staying square over that beam.
Okay, now let's do a couple.
I think I hit everything in my round offs. Do you have any questions on round offs?
Yeah.
I'll move on. Two back walk overs and front walk overs. Walkovers go, the start position is really important. Just show me, turn around that way for me, and then just show me arms up if it's really pointed. That's awesome. So just checking out this position is going to be a good start, okay? Making sure they're nice and tall and stretched up, and this back is nice and straight, okay? No sagging issues. Great starting position. As they go back, I want you to watch this bottom leg and what it does. Pretty much stays nice and tight. What you'll normally see from back in a basic JV gymnast is going to be a bend in this leg, okay? And that's going to give it all kinds of movement going on. So when you're watching, tighten up. When you're watching the back walkover, I sometimes put my hand here and I'll put it here so that I know what's going on with the back and I know that this leg is straight. Okay? So I'm fighting that knee bend if there is any. I would do a lot of spotting and a lot of more basics for back walkovers than that. In the middle of the back walkover, so now she has the beginning right, so now I'm going to check her middle and the step you have way. Okay. I'm going to look at this back. This is an awesome, okay, most of the girls have had a sag here, and I would say tighten up, push tall, and her shoulders are close. So that's what you want to check in the middle of your back walkover.
Yes,
okay,
right.
See that sagginess going on? Now push tall. Okay, so that's the correction that you want to do. That correction and that tall back gives them time to push tall in that handstand, and there should be no reason that there's a fall in a back walkover because number one, they can see the beam all the time. Number two, if they're off, that little bit of crookedness, that tallness press will fix that for you. Okay, one more time, a little bit. On the landing again. Watch those arms coming off the beam. She has a nice lift. They stay by the ears. They cover the ears. If you have a gymnast, do one more and drop your arms and your ears aren't covered. So you have a gymnast that's having trouble and she's not covering her ears, she's not pulling up her whole body. The pull from the beam starts with the arms, so those ears have got to be covered. So do one more and watch her arms. The whole back walkover, her ears will be covered. Covered, 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 covered all the way up. Okay, so that's something to look for.
Someone just not going very high. This is a great move.
To work on the shoulder work, if you had two blocks, you could put like a block to start their leg on and a block to end their leg on.
Still be a
where they're
over,
focusing on that handstand and they can stop themselves in that split and push tall. If you don't
they're
have
gonna be a little
spot,
over, but
they could work on that with
right.
each other and watch
so
each other
it,
do that.
It mimics
drill.
That round off flow really well. Yeah, they're going to be a little bit here, back leg, but it'll be coming this way. Because remember, it's going to take the board a little while to go down, a little while to come back up, before they're to the end.
Anybody? Yeah.
It depends on the kid. And what I usually do is, whatever shape their body works in, that's the one I go.
Okay. So have her head stay back. Her arms dropped up in a little bit, so I'd like a little bit more squeeze as you come up off the floor. But
when they're little, we do.
The head starts keeping that nice T position or lever, whatever term you use.
I wouldn't.
You'll watch her back leg lifts as she goes back. And she keeps her head back looking at the beam. This is one where you want to place something at the front of the beam and at the back of the beam. As she's upside down, she's focusing on her block at the back. And then if you have something at the end of the beam, she can focus on that. So I would have like, you know, a red block at this end, a blue block at this end, or a teddy bear at this end, and a fish over here, just to give her things to look at when she's starting the front walk over and when she's finishing the front walk
over.
So that second leg lifting up, and then when you finish, you want to think about the muscles in their legs that they're going to be feeling. So she's going to be feeling that, come back to your leg position. This foot hit the beam, a slight turnout is fine, okay? You want it as straight as could be. She's going to feel her first, her calf activate, then her hamstring, and then her glute muscle. And you also want to think about the squeeze of the inner thigh so that she squeezes over the top of the beam. So you want to tell the gymnast and show the gymnast, okay, it starts here, squeeze, squeeze, and then squeeze here for the landing. So do it one more time, thinking about all those
muscles. All right, think you can do it?
The more that he can feel it and think about it, the better.
I'm going to leave it here. But I would go a little higher.
Okay. And then a couple drills that... Sorry.
Okay, but wait, but you know what?
You give
the important
drum.
Part, you still have to see. Okay, this is if your kids are like... They're going down, they're leaving their chest down. This is going to help them hold their chest up. Sometimes we also stack blocks.
Okay. Really, so this is for the front walk over?
Like flip higher than the block.
A push in the bottom leg.
Okay. You have kids who are having trouble with rotation.
She's
going
to go back to the mat. If it didn't
Girls, this time I want you to try to snap.
And then she's going
to
come up.
Go to your back.
Get your foot on the
mat. I've been using this for years on suits.
But this is going to be that strong base leg for the front walkover. Okay, she's going to learn though the push in the hips, the head going back. No, it's hard, but do you feel a lot of work in that leg?
Yeah.
Okay, so this is a drill that you can obviously tell if she doesn't do front walkovers on beam. But if you had a girl that was really working front walkovers, this would be a drill that would take great control and build those muscles, okay? And make them be aware of what they need to do to squeeze to land on that beam.
Yeah.
So that's the one leg with the knee bent on the wedge. Any questions? Answer for you.
Okay, let's try one more time. Focus on pushing on your round-offs.
Thank you.
Thank you.
kids that you have coming through now have been trained on a handstand, right? So they're not necessarily really getting heel drive, and I'm finding that a lot of suit timers are going way up. Okay, so if we just do this. And then he still will work on his feet. Okay, trying to use that action and go up to the feet. Okay, and like overtrain the heel drive a little bit. Not as important for a handspring as it is actually for a seat. Okay, and all the blocking and flipping throws are the same for suits when you take those, right? Put those mats up to snap to the back. The other thing we do is if you have, like, just imagine. Questions, come grab you.